Hello, hello, and welcome back to Airport CEO, where we pretend to be an airport CEO. It's tough being a CEO. It's tougher than being an airport manager, I can tell you that. But that might just be because we played three iterations of airport manager, airport, sim airport. We played three iterations of that game, so we are at least a little bit aware of what was happening. But here is not the same. I am not aware of what is happening in this game at all. So having said that, we are doing okay. We are not doing really poorly. We're still learning the ropes of the game. We're still going through the entire tutorial, which is taking us step by step. And I should appreciate the people who made this tutorial. I mean, it's definitely a step by step process, but oh no. This fox is stuck in here. Oh, there's a little gap here. That's why. It's all taken care of. There are still gaps in the fence, but I think for the most part we are good. So we are waiting for this to get completed so we can learn about the baggage, the baggage thingies. Following that, we will operate basic baggage, secure conveyor belt system, operate remote stands, large aircraft and passport control, and with that things are done. I am excited for passport control because that is something which I have to go through every single time, and I always think that that's an interesting kind of dynamic, passport and customs, which I did miss a lot in Sim Airport. So if this game has implemented it much better, then that would be awesome. How are we doing financially though? Our loss has come down, definitely. So that's a good thing. We have very few passengers who are coming in. This is still not complete. Baggage handling takes a long while. But anyway, this is our very, very minimal airport. And we are selling what seems like books or CDs. I don't know what, but it's the same thing. Probably something in high demand. Probably Cyberpunk 2077. That's funny. And this looks like these are suitcases, although they could be filing folders, I'm not sure. There are some tangerines or oranges and some satellites, or maybe it's makeup things, isn't it? Probably. Do we have, like, if we click on the shop, can we see a list of things that the shop sells? We can't. That's interesting. We have two restrooms, one for men and one for women. And we have an office space with like six desks. Let's quickly go here, disable you and get rid of you. Because you are an eyesore, my friend. We have the check-in desks here. And then we have the security gates here, which leads in here. I kind of like how this is set up, like how the game handles security and whatnot, although some things are really, really confusing. Like, I have to put a door here. This is a door to let the security people in, which is weird. But that's fine. So R&D is completed. Extend your terminal and build a baggage bay. So we need to build a baggage bay. So baggage claim area. How are people exiting? They're exiting from here. So I can have baggage claim over here, I suppose. this could be baggage claim. This is a baggage bay and this is conveyor belts. So a baggage bay seems like it needs to be connected by roads and it accepts baggage. Now here's the thing, I don't know how this works, so I am just going to wing it, put it here like so, probably get the roads around. Must be placed inside what? Indoors? Inside a secure zone. Oh, alright. So I will have to assign this as a secure zone before I put it there. So let's go to zones. Let's go to secure zone. Let's say that this is supposed to be a secure zone too. I can't do that. Interesting. Where are you? Conveyor belt system. To and from baggage. Yes. So I can place it here. But that's weird. It has to go out, shouldn't it? Okay, let's place it and see what it wants. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is wrong. And we have conveyor belts. So the conveyor belts are pretty straightforward, I guess. They just go out and connect. But this is weird. Ramp agents per side. Station ramp agents per side. Okay. The airport baggage handling service is disabled. This baggage bay can't transfer baggage. So I can open it without connection to an aircraft stand and check-in desk or baggage claim. Alright, that makes sense. So I have to connect you somehow. Connect to baggage. Can't connect to baggage bay by handling a flight. Okay. Connect to baggage. Connect to baggage. Connect to baggage. This one. Are you connected already? You handling a flight? Alright. So maybe the agents will just get this. But we might need to have an area here where the agents can walk into. Make it a secure zone probably. Interesting issues. Let's preemptively do that. Let's get the terminal foundation and let's get this sorted out. Is that big enough? Probably not. Let's make it like so, and then I can have a door here, and then I can move this. If moving it is allowed, I don't know if it is or not. If not, we'll just delete it and then we'll have it here. See, it says connect the baggage bay to service roads. So which means we will need to do that at some point of time. So it has to be semi-open. Can't be like a completely closed off area. Huh, I know what I'm gonna do after this. After this episode and probably one more episode where I'm floundering around, I'll probably go and check out some tutorials to figure out how these things should be done. So let's open you up and then let's see if I can get service roads in here. I can get service roads in here. That's strangely awesome. So I can get indoor service roads. That's what it means. Let's get rid of this. Sure, why not? May as well do it right. Okay, so let's go here. Let's get the baggage transfer place thingy placed over here. Must be placed inside a secure zone. Of course, I knew that. Secure zone. You, my friend, will go here. That's good. Infrastructure. Yep. Go like so. And then I can still get the walls around. That's cool. I mean, I think it's cool. I'm not sure. Let's see how it pans out. Okay, so now this needs to get connected to these places. So connect you here. Connect you to this. Reconnect over here. Reconnect over here. And this can be opened. Cannot open without connection to aircraft stand and check-in desks or baggage claim. Aircraft stands is done. Check-in desk is one thing. So check-in desk has to be here. So from the check-in desk, we need to move it all the way here. Can we go underground is the question. So we have conveyor belts. We have these. How do I... Oh no. So I will need to get these out here. And then come in here and fit here, which means how am I going to do that? Let's do this. Let's get underground whatever's. Floor construction permit is for stairs, escalator, conveyor belt, escalator, terminal floors. I don't know if this does underground though. Tilt tray. What the hell is a tilt tray? All right, let's get floor construction permits and let's see how it goes from there. Because I mean, it doesn't make any sense us placing this here and then, yeah, it doesn't really make any sense. we need conveyor belts here which go down, conveyor belts here which go down. I don't know if we have hubs or not, most likely we don't. I don't know how the conveyor belt splits, so we need to take care of all of that. Baggage claim area is already done there. We shall see. Once this is complete, we will get a better idea of how it works. What else do we... Oh, we can't go and see the other ones. That's sad. Let's look at the economy. We're making $11 of profit. Average hourly profit. That's good. Income from aircraft is the most. From parking fees especially. That's the biggest contributor. Runway usage fees and all that is fine. We have an executive committee. We have Hai Pham, who is the COO. We have Marco Ferrari, who's the strategy director. Dmitry Ivanov, who is our procurement director. We don't have a HR director. We have a CIO. Enables auto planning, unlocks technology projects. All right. Set airport fees. We don't need that yet. Set salaries, set shifts and working hours, reduces salary cost by 15%. That's the HR director. That's okay for now. We don't have anything, so it's fine. Ooh! Look at this. This looks amazingly massive. Oh my god. This game is overwhelming. Oh, there's some things which got unlocked. So what is this? We have an escalator down and brilliant. So this is precisely what we need. We need an escalator down over here. Our funds, we don't have monies. Can we get more money in? We can repay this. With what money? We can't repay it. Let's just take another loan. Alright. And then this goes down. So if we go down, this should be here. I don't know if we need foundation or whatnot. But let's go up and let's get these conveyors down first. So let's get all of these down. That will give us the conveyors here, which means we can then build conveyor belts. All right. And then this has to go up. This is coming out, is it? All right. Oh my. So now this has to crisscross with this. So what I could do, just to make things a little bit easier, is to have an escalator down. This is going off, so this is coming up. So this has to be an escalator up, my bad. So we can have an escalator up. That's going up. I guess we can have it here. Yeah, and let's get this conveyor out like so. connecting to here, go down, and then get this coming out this way to join to this here. Yeah, so the input is all configured. Next we need the output. Let's see, do we need to build the conveyor thing going around? Probably. And this has an escalator down. No, this needs an escalator up. This needs an escalator up. Like so. Yep. Brilliant. Brilliantly done. Pat on the back for us, Kaleer. Pat on the back for us. Because we figured this out. Alright. So, with all of that done, this should all be connected properly. It's kind of like a small runoff, but I think that should be fine. So this is good because this gives us much more flexibility. We can have L-shaped or S-shaped or whatever shape we want the baggage delivery here to be, unlike previously where it was all a circle. So let's repair the runway. No need to repair you. So we just need to fix this small little stretch over here. And then we are all peachy. Do we need a baggage car? I feel like we do need to buy a vehicle. A baggage car vehicle. Stair truck, jet fuel, fire truck, ambulance. We don't have baggage cars here. It's because we are looking in the wrong place. Obviously. Baggage truck roofless. Large pull force baggage truck. Baggage truck with a roof. We need roofless or with a roof. I know what the difference is. Let's get it with a roof. Is it done? It's all done. So drag out baggage claim area, build a conveyor belt carousel, then open it. So we need to open this. So let's open this room. Okay. Connect your check-in desks to the baggage bay. So we need to connect this to here. And then we need to connect this to here. Okay. Connect baggage room area to baggage bay. So connect you to this. That's done. Make sure everything is activated. So I need to activate you. Open it. And this desk requires additional staff to operate. What kind of staff do you need to operate? We need service technician, ramp agent. What do they do? What do ramp agents do? Some extra ramp agents here. So let's get you, let's get you, let's get you. Three ramp agents should be fine. Make sure you have at least 8 ramp agents. We do. Okay, so I'm going to put a quick cut in this video. Do like and subscribe if you like the content I'm putting outside. Do comment if you think anything is comment worthy. And I'll be back in a quick bit with the next episode where we try to explore more how we can fix this airport up to a basic level so that we can go back out and then come back in and start a new airport where we know what it is that we are actually doing. Until next time, take care now. Bye-bye then.